What's up guys, Hong Nguyen, OG Fitness. Welcome to the channel. All right, let's dive in. Today's video, we're going to talk about, I'm gonna answer a question. Once again, I've been answering a lot of questions because you guys been asking, and I'm really happy to answer them, guys, so keep them coming. A lot of guys here in the community who actually have a lot more experience than me and who've been doing this longer. And you know, it's amazing to get their input too. So one thing I'm gonna start doing is that when some of the guys, they help answer questions in the comments, I'm going to take those comments and then I'm going to make a video and of course give them credit, and so I could answer them publicly like this so everybody gets to see it, right? And I appreciate every single one of you guys, honestly. Like I've been reading the comments lately and it's amazing, man. A lot of guys give me a lot of input. I'm learning a lot. So it's really, really fun, and I'm glad you guys are on this journey with me to towards my ultimate goal, which is essentially not only a black belt in judo, but to become a champ, right? I'm 41 years old, and I've been, you know, started a little bit late in life in judo, but I've been doing martial arts my whole life. This is a childhood dream of mine. I can't go to Olympics at this age. I might give it a shot. We'll never know, guys. You never know. If this thing blows up, this community here, you guys help me, we bring this up together. I mean, I could do this full time, you know, and I don't have to work anymore. So if I don't have to work and all I have to do is make content and share with you guys, I'm gonna make it so that you guys see what I'm actually doing in terms of training to go, you know, win my title. All right, how you like guys, the haircut? Yeah. Roman. I'm going to be trying out a judo dojo this week, and I want to know what tips you would give in identifying if the dojo is legit or a McDojo. Excellent question, Roman. Thank you for the question. Track record is the most important thing. So if you go to a judo club, and you could, if it's a judo club, you could actually check if they're under the federation or not. If it is a legit judo club, they have to be under the judo federation, USA Judo in this case. So you could see, you could just check USA Judo, and also you could go on the website of that that dojo, for example. See who the instructor is, see what their credentials are. If you're a black belt, you have to be certified, like you're registered in the Judo Federation. Just to be a black belt and to open a school, you have to have certain certificates that you're obligated to have, that you must have to actually be able to teach judo, have a school and all that. Doesn't necessarily mean you're good, but it doesn't necessarily mean you're bad too. It depends on the track record. So either their own personal track record as a coach, you know, what they've achieved in judo, if they achieved anything. If they didn't, that's fine. But then you can look at who they've trained. And then another way is to go there, right? Do a class, see how you feel, and then be observant. So be aware, be observant of what's going on, how he gives the classes, and especially like the randoris. And if you have a chance, I would suggest checking out other clubs too, other judo clubs. Now, if you don't have that chance and you don't know anything about judo, watch some YouTube videos on judo, like some big names. Look at the big names. But for the most part, judo, from my experience where I am, like some clubs are more competitive than others. Some clubs are recreational, but I mean, no one is, how do you say it, not legit. You know, in the judo world, it's like you have to, you know, there's a lot of values in that. And like, you can't just fake a black belt. You have to actually pass the exam. So even if you're not a competitor or like a hardcore, amazing fighter or anything like that, then you're still like, you still know the basics enough to actually be able to teach it, because there's a lot of requirements to get, not a lot, but there are requirements to get your black belt. Like you need 120 points in competition. You got to pass the exam. You got to demonstrate all the techniques, not all the techniques, but you got to, they just call them out at random and you got to demonstrate them. And then you got to do the kata exam too. So, I mean, that takes time. That could take anywhere between, once you get your brown belt, that process in itself could take you either a year or 3 years, depending on how you go about accumulating your points. If you compete, you get it faster. And if you don't, it takes a little bit longer. It's deserved, a black belt. And then to open a school, it's even another matter. It's like, you can't just be a black belt to open a school. You have to have other certifications that's going to allow you to open up the school. And it's always association with the federation. like the federation is pretty powerful, man. It's a big federation for judo, you know, Olympic sport and shit like that. I believe where I am, there's not a lot of MGDojo shit going on. Whereas of other martial arts, holy shit, yeah, that's a different story, man. Like the number one suggestion there is make sure that this school is actually recognized by USA Judo or IJF, International Judo Federation, all right? And of course, check the track record and all that. Try it out, maybe try a different school. And that's it. I hope that made sense, guys. So if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Hey, sharing the video, guys, helps me grow a lot. So if you guys could do that, that would be very much appreciated. Love you guys. See you guys in the next one. Peace. So thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and click on the notification bell. Also, there's a link down below. If you guys click on it, it's gonna bring you to a page where you could follow me on all my social media platforms. And you can also apply for coaching so that you guys can work directly with me. Also, one last thing, guys, if you have any questions, right, send me an email. That's the best way to reach me. I read them and I'll answer your questions, man. All right, peace.